Thank you, I'm Sirmaur. I'm deeply honored today to be part of this first ever TEDx talk. Thank you so much. The moment I got this topic, resurgam, I want to rise again. My story came into in my mind. The journey of an ordinary girl from a small town to the corporate world. I hope you enjoy my story. The journey of an ordinary girl from a small town to the corporate world. My mother is very intelligent and she was very ambitious, like many other women. She had a dream to pursue her career into academics. But the prevailing attitude of the women education during that point of time saw her getting married early, for which she couldn't complete her postgraduate degree. Further, the household responsibility of a large joint family did not allow her to take up a job in a high school in spite of having all the necessary qualifications. So my mother felt deeply that it was an injustice to her potential. And since then, she was determined to ensure that the same doesn't happen to her two daughters, that is me and my younger sister. Since our childhood days, our mother was on to us, making us realize the necessity of having our independent career. Over and above, getting married and having a family. So it is my mother who set the goal for my life, being a woman, to have an independent career and also be financially independent. I come from a very small town of Assam called Dumduma, where economic opportunities are very less. In my society, in my Dumduma, doctors were a figure of authority and respect. As a child, I was very fascinated to see a doctor in a white gown with a stethoscope, and more than that, the prefix doctor. I used to write everywhere in my notebooks, in my rough pages, as Dr. Kamalika Deka. Since my childhood days, I developed this aim in my life that I want to become a doctor. Being labeled as a good student with good marks during my high school days, I was utterly convinced that I can become a doctor in my life. And then, as you all can guess, I attempted twice for the medical entrance and every time I failed. And neither did I score good marks in my 12th board examination. I was totally devastated. I had no plans apart from becoming a doctor. I had no option B in my life. It seems my life has come to an end. And moreover, the humiliation from my relatives for not clearing medical entrance after two attempts and for not scoring good marks in my 12th board examination. It was then, in January 2002, then President of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, visited near my hometown for a festival. Dr. Abdul Kalam always ensured that during his visits, there should be a 30-minute slot to interact with the local children. And that is how I got an opportunity to listen to him. I heard from him what was his aim in life. His aim was to become an Air Force pilot. And what happened after that when he couldn't become an Air Force pilot? He told all of us to recite along with him. Dream, dream, dream. Dream transform into thoughts and thoughts results into action. And believe me, that was the day I realized, hey, it is not Kamalika who couldn't become Dr. Kamalika Deka, but it were there's so many successful people in this world who had their aim in life, but they couldn't achieve their aim, but they have taken the other route in the life which has really made them successful. If they can be become successful in the life, why can't I? And that was the day I decided that I will never look back again. I need to decide for my option B in my life. And that's how I decided that I will pursue my graduation with zoology honors, a subject which I really enjoyed studying. While I was pursuing my graduation, one of our family friends got a marriage proposal for me with a boy who was 12 years older to me, because they felt that I was hopeless in my studies because I couldn't score good marks in my 12th examination. Neither I could clear medical entrance even after two attempts. What is the point for, especially for a girl, to pursue her studies when she's not good at them? And also during that point of my life, my father had a big financial crisis. So they felt that, you know, I was wasting my dad's money. That was a day I completely fell down. It was just like a pariah. A student who was so popular during her school days has become like a brushed out crust. I fell again in my life. But it was my parents who gave me the confidence, who supported me and told me, Kamalika, you need to believe in yourself. Your hard work will always pay you off. During my graduation time, I had 3 years with me to figure out what I need to do in my life and also to salvage back the prestige from my friends and my relatives. Humiliation made me more focused, more determined that I need to focus on my studies with renewed intensity. During the point in my life, I opted for an option. I started developing my hobby, that is to participate in various debating competitions. During that point of my time, it was my dad who handholded me to take forward my hobby. The reason that I was very keen I developed debating as a hobby in my life was that I love to chat around with people. I always want to be the center of attraction in any gathering I am in. So I participated in a lot of debating competition in various national level and state level competition. It was my dad who always encouraged me. Though he was staying in Dumduma and I was staying in Guwahati, which is around 550 kilometers away, but he burned his midnight oil before every competition that I went for. Gradually, I did really well in various debating competition. I won a lot of state level and national level awards. And that was a boost in my self-confidence. Believe me, when you feel that you are doing good in something, that gives really a good motivation for you. And believe me, I also started doing well in my studies. And this debate also helped me out to clear my group discussions and interviews for my master's program in ICFI Hyderabad. Once I got into a business school, I paid with my blood and sweat and I arrived there. But I was again back into the crocky old self. It was again disaster looms in my life because I found the subjects of management to be very tough. I was not able to cope up with the complex theories of management when I studied. My friends, my batchmates were from all over the country. They have an amicable accent, formidable knowledge, and serotonin polish, which made me feel positively rustic. I wanted to go back home in the safer environment, but money was very tight. I had to take an education loan. During that time, my inborn ability of asking foolish questions in front of whoever it might be helped me to overcome my drawbacks, to clear my doubts. And that really helped me to settle down in a management course in ICFI Hyderabad. And also I realized it is very important for a person to get engaged. How do you get positively engaged with the institute, with your friends, with the people around? Gradually, things started moving on in a positive way. I started enjoying my management course. From my second SEM exam, I started getting scholarship from my institute. Everything was moving on very fine. One fine afternoon, 27th April 2008, I met with a very bad accident in Hyderabad. I was in coma. I had head injury and I was in coma. Doctor said there is a very less chance for me to survive. I was fighting with my life in the ICU of care hospital in Hyderabad. But it was all God's miracle that gradually my health started improving. And after a few days, I got discharged from the hospital. Though I was discharged from the hospital, but I was not able to perform like a normal person. Then again, it was my dad, my mom, and my sister who stood behind me and supported me to challenge with my life. It was my mom who just left everything of her own. She started staying with me in Hyderabad because during the point of time, I was pursuing my internship, summer internship with the company. There were only a few weeks left out where I had to submit my project reports and I couldn't function like a normal person. I was completely bedridden. My mom, who doesn't know how to use a laptop, helped me to type my project reports in MS Word. My mom, who is not very fluent in speaking English or Hindi, and Telugu was beyond imagination, she managed to live her life as well my life in a city like Hyderabad. So it was my mom during that point of time who proved me or who made me realize that nothing is impossible in this world. You can do when you have the will for it. And believe me, it was that point of time that it was my willpower where I realized I need to challenge my life. I need to fight for myself. Because I was studying in an education loan. If I had to drop for 1 year, will the bank disperse the remaining loan if I have a break in between? What will happen to my studies? Because my dad has a financial crisis. I need to fulfill my mother's dream to have an independent career. So it was my mother, and from my mother, I have learned, I have submitted my project report on time, and I started continuing my third semester class after a few months. So after dwelling for 2 years in Hyderabad, I landed up a job there through my campus placement. I was very happy. I could fulfill my mother's dream. I could fulfill the goal in my life to have an independent lifestyle. I took a place for rented in a very renowned address in Hyderabad, and I was ready to mesmerize the world with a smart HR ideas. 15 February 2007, my first day in my first job. After my joining formalities were over, I went to meet my first boss. In the first introductory note, he was too blunt with me. He told me, "Leave all the theories that you have learned in your B school. You need to be very practical in the corporate world. Don't come to office for next 15 days. Be there on the stores. Understand what is consumer behavior, what is people's behavior, what are the employees' expectations." My boss was never happy with me if I did the regular job flawlessly. He was a man who always wanted newness at work. If I was late for office for 5 minutes, he made my life hell. So it was from my first boss I learned these two mantras in the corporate world. That is, mantra number one, start before time. And two, you always need to innovate at your work. If you are happy with your old cheese, probably a day will come when you become extinct. After settling down in the corporate world, now I had to face the next challenge, or probably you might say, the destiny of my life. I was ready for the next chapter of my life, that is marriage. My family wanted to get married to a well-qualified boy who maintains the status of a family that my parents were wanting for, and equally, he has a good professional career. Many families want their daughter-in-law to be well-educated, to have a good job. But believe me, things are not that simple. Looking at my educational background, looking at having a lucrative offer, job offer, I got a lot of marriage proposals. And through one of my family connections, my marriage was fixed with one of the boys from a smart corporate world. Probably he was a man which was a dream for every girl or for every family, for parents to marry their daughter. smart, handsome, well-settled boy, well-educated. But gradually I got this hint from him that he wanted his wife to be a part, to be a family-oriented, probably to cut down the time after office to spend more time at home and probably to take care of the baby. Then I realized, hey, it is not Kamalika's goal. Though it was sounding like, you know, I was blowing my trumpet, but it took months for me. I had to really gather my guts and I had to say no to that relationship. A biggest thing in my life, saying no for a marriage proposal. But I was very positive. I always believed that when I have not done something bad to others, good will happen to me. My hard work will always pay me off. And believe me, for a woman, after her marriage, support from her husband is very, very important. It is my parents who really supported me when I was falling down in every step of my career, from the journey from a small town to the corporate world. I could rise up all the time because my parents handholded me. But once I got into a corporate world, after my marriage, it is very important how do my husband support me. Nowadays in the corporate world, we talk about gender diversity and inclusivity. But we are talking about the corporate need to revisit the policies where they would encourage more women to come and join. If you look at the ratio, the percentage of women after taking a maternity break, the dropouts are much higher because many women doesn't have the courage to come back to work. But it is my feeling, it is very important for every corporate to revisit the policies and encourage more number of women to come and join job and to increase the leadership position of women. But at the same time, it is also very important, the mindset at home. If you don't have a supporting husband, it is very, very difficult for any woman that you talk about to concentrate at her work. As somebody said, the biggest glory is not ever failing every time, but to rise every time you fail. Failing is a monster. We always need to find out a way. How do we really work out and fulfill our cherished goals and dreams? And with this ups and downs in my life, I have believed in this few mantras of my life, which I take as a mantra in every step I take forward. And these are, set goals for yourself. It is very important. Where do you head? Which destination are you going for? Be honest and true to yourself. Have discipline in your life. Always have option B in your plan. Never underestimate yourself based on what worlds tell you. Believe in yourself. Take failure as a learning. Look out for the trigger, which is the boost for your motivation. Engage yourself in a good company. Always try to do things differently, which will always differentiate you from others. That's all. Thank you.